happening. You know, everything shouldn't happen just in isolation. It's nice that everyone's collaborating, and introducing robotics has really helped with that.
Ma'am, my first question to you is, you have been a very early adopter of STEAM education. What was the trigger which made you think that it is important to have STEAM education in school? Could you tell us some of your insight on the same?
Okay, so I think I have been reading about STEM and STEAM education for a few years now, and reading about how successful it is in schools, and you know, the importance of kids learning the various skills through STEAM education that they need in today's world. So I think the trigger was when it was actually our CEO's son who was doing robotics in school, and he saw the change in his son. So he suggested, you know, why don't we try it out in our schools as well. He was very convinced about, you know, what his son was learning and the skills that he was learning. So that is one major reason why we introduced STEAM education in our school. And the fact that our kids were so excited, you know, to learn, and the various things that they were doing, the feedback from the teachers and the principal, I think it's all been wonderful so far.
Wonderful, thank you. Ma'am, some schools opt robotics or STEM education after school activity, whereas some school integrate, like the school of your ACT school. So how do you see this particular way of schools weighing after school activity or integrating it all in the curriculum?
Okay, I think the general mentality in Indian society is that there should be importance placed only on maths and science, you know, the regular subjects, and that anything extra should be an after-school activity. They don't really see importance of integrating it into the school system, onto the day, onto the timetable. But we believe that all this is important for the growth and development of the child. You know, children have different strengths. They might be good at maths, or they might be good at English, or they might be good at sports, and we need to encourage them in all aspects and not only focus on certain things that the education system or the board or the society is demanding. That's what we believe at ACTS, and that is why we have incorporated it into the timetable.
Wonderful. We also saw many children of your school participating in Bangalore Tech Summit. So how do you see this as experience for a child and the school? And how do you see the school and should encourage more of children to participate in such activities?
I think in today's world, there's so many more opportunities for the children. You know, it's not going to just be a desk job or just an engineer or somebody in a lab. There are so many other jobs where they're going to have to use more of their confidence or their communication skills or problem solving skills, critical thinking, all these things which robotics is actually offering. So these opportunities that pop up for our children, it's preparing them for life. You know, that our school is not just giving them an exam paper to answer or a test to get good marks at, but we're also, through things like robotics, giving them opportunities that are helping them with the skills that they will need later on in their lives.
Ma'am, congratulations for one of your students, Master Naveen, has been identified and been appreciated by Intel India. And he also is a part of the iLead for India Foundation, and we're likely to see him getting to the boot camp. So a very nice ecosystem which is getting developed for children to do it. So how do you see such ecosystem for schools coming up, from the government of India as well as, you know, partnering companies which is trying to foster an ecosystem like that?
It's great that these things are happening. You know, everything shouldn't happen just in isolation. A company is functioning on its own, or the government is trying to do stuff, and schools doing their own thing. It's nice that everyone's collaborating towards the growth of our students, the future of our country. And I'm so proud of our student who was able to achieve this, and I'm sure he's, you know, already on a high, and many other students are going to follow suit.
Congratulations once again, and I'm sure he's going to go to the boot camp and bring laurels to the school. To the parents, he's going to make them feel proud, and I'm sure he's going to inspire more children who could think of participating in the coming fourth year.
Thank you. Thank you.
every organization has a vision, and as ACTS group of schools, I'm sure you also have a great vision for the future of children and for the people who work with you. So how do you see that integration of robotics or as a STEAM education is aligning to the vision of your ACTS group of schools?
In all of our ACTS schools, we look at the holistic development of the child. You know, not just one aspect, but all the aspects. And introducing robotics has really helped with that. And in broad terms, you know, the vision of ACTS is to build up each child so that they in turn can be a part and contribute to the society that they grow up into, and to be responsible citizens and, you know, to participate responsibly. So I think all these things that we introduce in our schools is always part of the vision and the mission of the organization.
I think it's very encouraging and beautifully put across that it is important whatever we choose, we and align them to the vision of our organization and try to reach that particular goal out of it.
Yeah.